ओम श्री साई राम। माई मोस्ट हम्बल प्रणाम एट द लोटस डिवाइन फीट ऑफ मदर साई। टुडे वी स्टार्ट आवर कंप्यूटर क्लास। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डू थ्री ओमकार्स, ज्वाइन योर हैंड्स, क्लोज योर आईज। ओ साई राम, टुडे वी स्टार्ट लेसन नंबर 6, फॉर्मेटिंग अ प्रेजेंटेशन। आ लेसन नंबर 6 इज फॉर्मेटिंग अ प्रेजेंटेशन। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर यू लर्न अबाउट द पावर पॉइंट, हाउ टू वी क्रिएट द प्रेजेंटेशन and take a new slide, all that things. In this chapter, we will learn how to we format that slide or make our presentation attractive. If you have a presentation with many slides, you may want all of them to look the same. All the slides must have the same themes, fonts, colors, effects, and backgrounds. This is when you need to use a slide master. In this chapter, you will learn how to format a presentation using the slide master and to use animations and transitions. First of all, we learn about the slide master. A slide master is a slide that stores information about the fonts, colors, effects, backgrounds, themes, and the size of placeholders and their position in a presentation. What is a slide master? A slide master is a slide that stores information about the fonts, colors, effects, backgrounds, themes, and the size of placeholders and their position in a presentation. This is the definition of slide master. Then the changes you make to a slide master are applied to all the slides of the presentation. They will also be applied to all new slides added later on. You can use the slide master to save time when you have a presentation with lots of slides. The series of slides below the slide master can be used to modify different slide layouts. You will learn about this in higher class. Whatever slide master you choose, that applied on all your slides of the presentation. And after that, applying the slide master, you add new one slide that also affected with the slide master. Now working with the slide master, to make a presentation using the slide master, follow these steps. How do you use the slide master? To use the slide master, you follow these given steps. First of all, click on the view tab, then click on the slide master option in the master view group. The presentation will switch to slide master view and an additional tab named slide master appears on the ribbon. In the left navigation pane, scroll up and select the first slide. This is the slide master. To use a slide master, first of all you click on the view tab. In the view tab, you can choose the slide master option. Then after you can see another group, slide master view group. on your tab. Then you can see one another tab on your ribbon that's called as a slide master. Then after adding a text box to the slide master, to add a text box to the slide master in a presentation, follow these steps. Open the slide master view. Click on the slide master in the left navigation pane. To select it, click on the insert tab. Click on the text box option in the text group. Click and drag the mouse to the slide to draw a text box. Type the text in it. Click on the slide master tab. Click on close master view button. The text box will appear on all the slides. Whatever changes and whatever you do on a first slide, that's your master slide, that will be apply on all slides. If you add one extra text box, that will be apply on your all slides. You can see here figure 6.2, steps to add a slide text box to the slide master. And after adding that text box, you have to close the master view. Applying a theme to the slide master. After completing your adding the text box, if you want to give the background colors and formattings through the themes in your mobile, you are already using the themes. In the computer also we are using the themes. Same thing, we can also give the themes in a PowerPoint presentation. You can apply a themes to the slide master. This action will apply the new theme to the entire presentation. To apply a theme to the slide master, follow these steps. First of all, open the slide master view and select the slide master. Click on the theme drop down arrow to open a list of themes. Then select a theme of your choice, for example culture themes. Click on the close master view button on the slide master tab. The new theme will be applied to all the slides of the presentation. Whatever theme you select for your slides, that themes will be applied on all the slides. There are so many different types of the themes. You can choose any one theme. After applying the themes, if you want to change the colors, combination in all the colors, that can also be you changed. Changing the color theme on of a themes, you can also change the color theme of a theme in a slide master. To change the color theme, follow these steps. First of all, open the slide master view and select the slide master. Click on the themes drop down arrow to open a list of themes. Select the theme of your choice. Now click on the color drop down arrow to open a list of colors. Click and select a color theme. The new color theme will be applied to all the slides of the presentation. Whenever you want to any changes in a slide master, first of all you open the slide master view. Then after you can apply any changes. If you want to change the color of theme, you can select. There are so many themes of color. You can choose any one. And that applied on all slides of your presentation. You have to complete checkpoint on your notebook. Next is changing the background color. If you want to fill the background color, you can use this option to fill the background colors. And there are so many options are there. You can also change the background color of each slide To change the background color, follow these steps. Click on the drop-down arrow of the background style option in the background group on the Slide Master tab. A list of background appears. Click on the Format Background option. The Format Background dialog box opens. Click on the Fill option, it already not selected. Select the Solid Fill option if already not selected. Click on the Color drop-down arrow to open a list of colors. Select a color of your choice. Click on Apply to All. Click on Close. Similarly, you can use the other fill effects such as gradient fill, picture or texture fill and pattern fill. There are different options to fill the background. You can fill simple colors, gradient colors, pictures of your computer, textures, patterns, whatever you want to fill on a background, you can use it by using these steps. And after selecting a color, picture, pattern, texture, you have to click on the Apply to All. It's your effect or your background color will fill on your all slides of a presentation. Using the gradient fill option, you can also format the background of slide using the gradient fill option. Some other options available under the gradient fill option as are follow. Click on the preset color drop down arrow to select preset colors. Click on the type drop down arrow to select the option from the list. There are so many options in a gradient fill option. You can choose any one. You can see here in a figure 6.6 and 6.7. You can also manage the color, mixing of color, and change the color of also of your preset colors. Here you can see in this figure 6.6 and 6.7 preset color options and type options. You can choose whatever type you want to apply. Here you can see also direction option is there also, and gradient stop option is also there. You can totally modify the background colors, all that things. Click on the direction drop down arrow to select an option. Click and drag the slide under gradient stop to increase or decrease the height of the colors. You need to apply formatting effect to the slide master only. The other slide of the presentation automatically get formatted. I previously told you students, whatever you applied on the slide master, that will affected automatically on all slides of your presentation. Then, using the picture or texture fill option, you can format the background using the picture or texture fill option. Click on the texture drop down arrow to select a texture for the background. There are so many textures are there. You can select any one texture to apply on your background of slide. Using the pattern fill option, you can also make your personalized attractive by using the pattern fill option. There are 48 patterns available under this option. How many patterns are there? 48 patterns are there. You can choose the color of pattern, foreground color or background. There are two colors are there. You can choose both color for your pattern, and then after you can apply any one pattern from the 48 patterns. After the formatting, You need to give the animation, means all the effects. After the formatting, you need to give an animation to your presentation. Any special effect that is added to the text and object on a slide is known as an animation. This is the definition of animation. Animation helps to draw the attention of the viewers toward the important points on a slide. To apply an animation effect, follow these steps. Click on the object you wish to animate. In the case of text, select the text you wish to animate. Click on the Animation tab. Click on any option in the animation group. For example, the fade option, you will see a preview of the selected animation effect on the slide. You can select individual objects and apply different animation effects to each of them. There are so many animation options are there. You can choose anyone, but first of all, you select the object to whom you want to apply the animation. One by one, you can select the object and you can give the different animation options. Next is the transitions. Transitions are motion effects that are seen when you move from one slide to the next during a slide show. You can control the speed of transitions. You can also add sound to them. Transitions make presentation attractive and interesting. To apply a transition effects to a slide, follow these steps. First of all, click on the slide to which you want to apply the transitions. Click on the Transition tab. Choose a transition effects in the transition to this slide group. You will see a preview of the chosen effect of the slide. Whatever effect you select, you can see the preview of that effect. If you are okay for that effect, then you click on that particular effect to apply on your slide. Then after, click on the drop-down arrow of effect option. Select the direction that the transition should appear from. Press the Control key and click on the slide to which you wish to apply the selected transition effect. To apply the selected transition effect to all the slides, click on Apply to All. Here you have to, both options are there. You can apply one by one different transition effects to your slide, or you can apply to all option is there also. Whatever effect you choose, and if you want to apply to all the slides, you click on the Apply to All. That particular effect will be apply on all slides of your presentation. Now keywords. Slide master, a slide that store information about the fonts, colors, effects, backgrounds, themes, and the size of positioning of placeholders in a presentation. That's called as a slide master. Next is animation. Any special effect that is added to the text and object on a slide. It's called the animation. Transitions, motion effects that are seen when you move the one slide to the next during a slide show. It's called the transition effects. All of you write down these keywords on your notebook, and summary also you write down on your notebook. Next time I will send you exercise. You complete that on your notebook or textbook. Today's class is over. Now join your hands, क्लोज योर आइज, डू द शांति मंत्र, ओ। शांति 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 ही। साईं राम, टेक केयर, थैंक यू।